Drone's reconnected now. Hey, Gaia. Me again.
Welcome back, Aloy. Where shall we resume?
Beta's convinced we won't be able to capture Hephaestus. With that attitude, do you really think she'll be able to build the rig and pulse generators?
It may take some coaxing, but with some assistance, I am confident she will.
I don't get her, Gaia. She's so quick to assume we'll fail. She's nothing like what I thought she'd be. I guess it'll be best if she stays here when we go to Gemini. All this data I've picked up in ancient bunkers and ruins. I guess I never really thought that other people would be looking at it.
Based on my observations, your companions engage quite frequently with this material. Erend has asked on numerous occasions about birthday parties. He appears perplexed by the tradition of serving a sweet confection, as it conflicts with the Oseram tradition of serving sparkling stout ale. He also suggested we host a party for you, as a surprise.
Yeah, no thanks.
That is what I predicted.
Is Catalo getting along with everyone?
Yes, though he prefers to spend most of the time alone. He appears to be collating data on war machine progression and significant battles during the Pharaoh Plague, to aid in the creation of a war map of Operation Enduring Victory. I believe he aims to study the tactics of old world warfare.
I'd be interested in seeing that.
It appears to be a private pastime for him. He has repeatedly declined my offers to assist his research.
So now that you have Aether, Demeter, and Poseidon, how's the biosphere looking?
In the local region, conditions have improved. Superstorms have subsided. Water sources have been purified, and soil conditions remediated. These improvements will stave off environmental collapse for a few additional months.
Well, with luck, soon you'll have Hephaestus. Then you'll be able to fix the biosphere for good, right?
Correct. I will be able to design and produce robotic agents to permanently reverse the environmental damage that has accumulated.
So our plan to capture Hephaestus. Let's go over it again.
As you wish. Thanks to Beta's test, we now know that Hephaestus will not respond to your Alpha clearance, which is why you will need to procure Ted Farrow's Omega clearance.
Right. From his personal bunker, Thebes.
While you are gone, I will assist Beta in building the transport rig and pulse generators. When we get to Gemini, I will need to be installed on one of the facility's cores. The second core is for Hephaestus. Using Omega clearance will allow you to trap it.
And then you'll be able to absorb it.
Not quite. You will need to manually remove Hephaestus's malicious code before the merge.
How long will that take?
There are calculations I still must run, but I estimate a few hours.
And during that time, the others will create a distraction for us using the pulse generators, right?
Correct. They will each take position at a cauldron door and fire off their device. The energy surge should mask our activities until the merge is complete.
And then we'll have everything we need to defeat the Zeniths. Sounds like a plan. There's something I've been wondering. How could Ted Farrow create a clearance level higher than Alpha? Elizabeth made sure he wouldn't interfere with the project.
It is plausible he tasked his own engineers with creating a back door to the Zero Dawn system, without Elizabeth's knowledge. My predecessor did not even know of its existence until he activated it to purge the Apollo database. It is, in effect, a blind spot. One that will allow us to subdue Hephaestus. Unfortunately, thanks to Beta's information, we know where Omega clearance may be procured.
Right. Somewhere in San Francisco. So the facility where I recovered Demeter used to be a Faro Agricultural Research Facility. It's where they created the biomass conversion system, but also adamantine wreath. Did Elizabeth know they were working on that?
It is likely she was briefed on other efforts to combat the machine swarm. Though her focus was devoted only to Zero Dawn.
That makes sense. But they actually got the wreaths to work. If they've been able to deploy it against the Faro Plague in time...
Using the data you recovered on the project, I ran several simulations and have concluded that it would never have worked. In all scenarios, the Faro war machines would eventually hack and deactivate the wreath before they could contain the swarm.
So Zero Dawn really was the only solution. There was a lot of data in the greenhouse facility about agriculture. Do you think it'll help the Quen fix their homeland?
I will run a query. Complete. The data contains information about novel crop production methods, which may be beneficial to the tribe in the long term.
But new crops aren't going to save the world. So I guess it's on us.
It is.
So Gemini has two data cores. I've never seen a cauldron like that. But you mentioned something about seismic activity?
When my predecessor attempted to build the cauldron, construction was disrupted by a series of earthquakes. The data core had already been built, but the rest of the facility sustained damage. So she began again. A second core was built. However, when more tremblers occurred, she abandoned the site.
Lucky for us. Are the quakes still happening?
No. Though they did also create instabilities in other facilities in the region.
See you later, Gaia.
Until next time, Aloy.
Aloy, you think we can talk? What's this I hear about you going west?
Turns out we need one last thing before we can grab Hephaestus.
Because it would have been too easy otherwise. Oh, before I forget. Here. Something to commemorate our mission. We did good together.
Yeah, we did. Bet you're used to that focus by now.
Well, I can hit machines in their weak points. I guess that's something. I wish all the other data was as easy to deal with. Now, to be honest, it's hard to understand half of what's on there. And then the other half reminds me, well, this isn't a fight you can win by just waving a hammer. Which is kind of what I do. But hey, that just means I gotta study harder. Now, make myself useful.
Just give it time. You've been looking at any interesting data?
I asked Gaia to find me something to look at a while back. And she found the mother of all forges. They called it sports. Turns out the old ones spent a lot of time tackling and punching each other for points in one game or another. Are you mixing some solid food and fresh ale? I bet half the claim will be lining up to watch.
Anything happen I should know about?
Zoe asked us to help her bring more plants in here. Not for eating, apparently. Yeah, if you ask me, place is fine as it is. Now, metal might be plain, but it's sturdy. Nothing wrong with that. Who needs a bunch of vegetation?
How are things with Catalo? You still scared of him?
Oh, she thinks she's funny. Actually, I played strike with him. I had to fill in most of the conversation myself, but I'm still alive.
Glad to hear it. I need to get going.
I think I know the answer, but are you sure you don't need any help? Gaia mentioned this other tribe you found, the Quen. They sound like a nasty bunch.
I can handle them. In the meantime, Varl will help you get ready for what comes next.
Take care of yourself, Aloy.
Aloy, you're here. Did you meet with the Quen already?
Not yet.
After all the trouble you went through getting those subfunctions, seems unfair you have to deal with these Quen on your own, too.
It's safer this way. They think I'm Sobek, or something like that. They won't hurt me, but I doubt they'll be so kind to anyone else.
If you say so. Let me know if you need anything before you go.
You better not be slacking off on your studies while I'm gone.
And risk Zoe coming after me? I value my life. In fact, I've been reading about Ted Farrow, how he destroyed the world and crawled into a hole after killing those who saved it.
He definitely was a piece of work. I hope Zoe's not upset I'm distracting you from your training.
Yeah, I don't think you have to worry about that.
What do you mean? What happened?
Before Zoe found a way to fix the land gods, I suggested that when Gaia was fully restored, she could just make new ones.
Well, once we get Hephaestus, that's definitely a possibility.
That's what I said. But I guess there was something about my tone she didn't like. She got pretty raw, said I didn't understand the way her tribe feels about those machines. Which is true, of course, and the last thing I'd ever want to do is dismiss their traditions. But I was trying to look at things differently, more like you, you know? To see a machine as just a machine.
Yeah, I guess I led you into trouble there, didn't I?
Not your fault. Don't worry.
Did you talk to Zoe after your fight?
I suffered through a few hours of glaring silence. Then she seemed to move on. Sort of. How do people do this? How do I know if the next thing I say won't blow up in my face? What if an apology is not enough next time?
You give her a stuffed animal?
You're the worst. You know that?
What makes you think I know anything about any of this? You're on your own.
Abandoning me again, huh? Well, if she kills me next time, it's on you.
Well, Beta and Gaia built the rig. Can you get everyone ready for the mission ahead?
Of course.
What is it?
Nothing. It's just that everything's about to change. We'll get Gaia, and she'll help us set things right. No more zeniths, no more derangement. It'll be a different world. I welcome it, but I wonder how the Nora will react. And the Carja, and well, everyone.
Let's just focus on fixing Gaia for now.
You're right. We've got an angry AI to take down.
If I get Omega clearance, and then we grab Hephaestus, we might finally have the advantage over the Zeniths.
Can't wait to see their faces as they stare down a bunch of charging Thunderjaws.
Better them than us, for once. I'll be in touch if I need anything.
We'll be ready. Everyone's been briefed on the pulse generators as well.
Good.
Aloy, I hear you're going further west past the Tanakh clanlands.
Do you know anything about the area?
Only hearsay. The Utaru tell stories of an island that lies beyond the western coast. They call it the Isle of Spires. It is said the Old Ones built towers there that touched the sky, so they could live far away from the Earth that bore them. As if they didn't want to be reminded that they'd one day return to it.
Sounds like something Ted Farrow would do. How much have you read on Ted Farrow?
Enough to wonder how a man who worked so hard to heal the world once could let greed and pride condemn it so easily. For one spirit to diminish in such a way, I'm not sure if I should hate him or pity him.
It looked like you were working on something over there.
With Gaia now growing in strength, I've been trying to find a way to heal the land gods, even if some people think I should give up on them.
Already said I was sorry.
Your friend thought it'd be a good idea to replace the land gods with new machines when Gaia recovers.
It wasn't.
The land gods have taken care of our people for generations. They are not some broken toy to be thrown away. Even if they are just machines doing their job, to abandon them in their time of suffering seems cruel.
I'm sure Varl understands that too.
He does now. I had to get pretty mad at him at first, though.
You know I can hear you guys, right?
Anything interesting happen while I was away?
Aaron told us how you tracked down the Oseram supplying Regala with machines. In fact, he's quite adamant about relating the tale at least twice a day. But I can tell it meant a lot that you asked for his help.
I wouldn't have been able to track them down if it wasn't for him. You ever play that board game Aaron set up?
Strike? I'm the one who gave it to him. I was hoping it'd distract him enough to spare us that ruckus he calls Death Metal. No such luck.
You and Varl doing okay? Training, I mean.
We're doing fine. Although I admit it'd be nice to take a small break from studying, just the two of us. But then who'd look after Aaron?
There's always Catalo.
Leave aloud Oseram with a brooding Tanakhth. What could go wrong?
What's everyone been up to?
I've been trying to share some of my meals with Beta. Thought it might help her feel more at home. Maybe even get her to sleep up here instead of in that dark basement. She would not be moved.
I appreciate you trying.
Patience reaps the best harvest. I'm not giving up hope yet.
Any progress with your plan for the land gods? Is the reboot code ready?
It is. But there is difficult work ahead. Gaia warned me that because the land gods are linked together in a network, the code must be delivered to all of them. Most are in Plainsong, but in recent years, three of them wandered off. So, Ti, and Do.
We have to find them?
No. We know where they are, but they're hard to reach. So wandered into a lake and sank. Do ventured into a dangerous canyon, and Ti broke down amidst a herd of machines.
Okay. Tell you what. You go to Plainsong, handle all the land gods there. I'll take care of So, Ti, and Do. I'll need their locations, plus the reboot code.
I'm sending the data to you now. My people made shrines near where each land god faltered. When you see them, you'll know you're close. And once again, thanks for your help.
We're not gonna let your people starve, So. I promise. Well, I should get going. Hopefully I can bring back what we need to capture Festus. After that, I'm gonna need everyone's help.
We'll be ready.
Understand this.
I've been tackling the design of the Ag Lab. Place is gonna have a lot of seed stock to work with. My favorite? Sample 626. Calotropis gigantea. The crown flower. We used to have one in our backyard. Butterflies always fluttering around. Every morning, August would run out there to check under the leaves. See if any caterpillars turned into chrysalises. Now, I'd like to imagine that the future will be filled with them.
Beta's so frustrating. I don't get how she can be so negative all the time. I mean, we're clones of the same woman, and yet she couldn't be more different from Elizabeth.
The matriarchs would cry here.
Hey, you got a second?
I suppose.
So do you have everything you need to build the rig and pulse generators? Gaia sent me the schematics. The designs are modest, without the capabilities of Hephaestus, but they should work. Not that it matters without a mega clearance. I'll find it. Just try to have the transport ready by the time I get back. So, aside from Varl and Gaia, who else have you been talking to?
Zoe told me how you met after your escape from the Hades Proving Lab. I had no idea you were severely injured.
If the Xenus had killed you, life on Earth would be doomed. My escape would have been for nothing.
But they didn't kill me. And thanks to Varl and Zoe, I was able to recover. You said you and Varl talk sometimes. What about?
He told me about your tribe, the Nora, and the proving ritual you did. I told him if I was born into the tribe, I'd never be able to do the proving.
It does require a lot of physical training, but there are plenty of other roles besides being a hunter.
I don't think I'd be suited for any of them.
Well, I guess it's a good thing you're not a Nora, then. That's enough for now.
Good.
I just think she talks a lot. You would too.
Aloy, I hear you're heading to the coast. If you need to resupply en route, I suggest stopping in Fall's Edge. It's a lowland clan village southwest of the Grove. In the heart of the jungle.
Got it. Thanks for the advice. seems quieter when it snows.
I see you, champion. Sit, please.
You shouldn't miss this chance to trade.